right now, chapter 4. This is where we're going to create your first data protection rule. This is where we're going to block social security numbers going to the cloud or to the web. Now, they're both very different. The web would be if we brought up a web interface, like through a URL or through a browser, and tried to deposit something through Dropbox that way, or we have a client vector, so we have to protect against both of them. Now, as we start to look at this screen here, this is the classification area. We're going to start everything right here in the definitions area and work our way backwards. Now, just like we did with anything else, these are going to be screens that we're just going to have to become familiar with. Now, down here at the bottom, we have social security numbers that are built in, and we're going to duplicate them. We're going to uncheck this little box here so we can just single out this one particular one that we've duplicated, and we're actually going to rename it. In this case, we're going to call it Corp Social Security Number. Now, down here, you'll notice that we have no validation. This comes out of the box this way, and I know that you're going to need to make this change in order to eliminate some false positives. So you're going to edit each of these four items and go down near the bottom, and it would make sense if we're looking to isolate this match based on a social security number, you'd go to SOC, but in this case, it's going to be US Social Security Number. And we're going to rinse and repeat and do that with all of the remaining items all the way down the bottom. Go to the US Social Security Number, and then eventually what will happen is if we try to eliminate the false positives, we're going to have a leg up on it, because if we try to provide a number like 111 and all ones, that would obviously not be a real social security number. And in this way, what we can do is during our test, we're going to show you when we deposit all ones out to a vector, it's going to go right through because it's not real. So we're really trying to finite down what it is we're going to see. Now, over here in the classification tab, we're going to basically marry a tag with what we've just created, in this case, social security numbers. So we created one called Company A, and you'll notice here, as we start to get close here, we're going to save this classification. And then when we start looking at defining this, we have to go in, create a classification. We're going to browse over and uncheck that box so we can isolate that corp social security number that we created just a couple of minutes ago. Perfect. Now let's name this Company SS Numbers and save it. Of course, you can name it whatever you want. Now what has happened is we've created a classification and married it to a what we call a tag ID. If we go up here to the tag ID and we click edit, you'll see that there's a unique number, very much like a social security number, that is unique to this particular classification called Company A SS Numbers. Now we've done all the hard work. Now what we're going to do is go up to menu on our EPO server, go to the DLP Policy Manager. And now what we have to do is we have to create a rule, and it will be our first rule. It's going to be our data protection rule. Rule sets. That's where our device rules are, remember? So now we're going to create actions, new rule. And we'll type in here, blocking SS numbers to the cloud or web. There it is. Now the tab we have to choose is data protection for our data protection rule, and we choose web protection from the actions menu. And we're going to say block SS numbers to the web. We're going to enable it. And the severity, of course, would be higher than it would be if we were just doing a device insertion. So we're going to now say Company A SS numbers will be the classification, and the reaction is going to be that we're going to block it. This is the first time we actually use user notification, though. And what we're going to do is try to isolate down web protection. So we're going to choose the very first item. Another one that you see down there is edit, and I've already created one in the past for some other testing I was doing. We're going to report this incident. Of course, you could also store it for evidence later on, but in this example, we're just going to do that. Now that we've created the web, we're going to do the very same thing, but we're going to go up to the top and choose Cloud Protection. So let's name this Block SS Numbers to the Cloud. At least we're consistent. Now I'm going to select the Company A SS Numbers because that is our classification. And I'm going to bypass the state right now because I want to show you another way that we can enable that. Now up here it says, hey, you forgot to put a reaction in, silly. So we're going to go over to the reaction tab. It's pretty good at self-regulating what you're doing and if you make any mistakes along the way. Here we're going to choose cloud because we need a notification, and we'll choose the one that's canned for McAfee and set the report incident to enable. Now notice over here that we have not enabled it. So if you happen to make the mistake, you can go to actions, change state, select enable. You could do it this way, or you can do it in the rule itself. By golly, I think we're just about ready to assign this over to our policy that goes to all the clients. And if you look over all these different icons, you'll see that we have our device rules, and the very top line would be where we have our web and we have our cloud by just a visualization of the icons. Okay, so over to the policy assignment tab we go, down to actions, and we're going to assign once again the blocking rule that we just created over to the blocking policy, and then we're going to, of course, apply it. Fantastic, that's done. Now over to the client we go. We're going to do a collect and send props. We're not going to wait for the ASCII, and we'll notice here that this is going to pop to revision ID number 4. So through video magic here, we're going to change these screens up. Here's our SS number test. It's all ones, and we're going to copy it, and we're going to put it into our client, or all the folders that are on the client itself that sync up to the cloud. And you'll notice here that there's no pop-ups. Why? Because remember, we did that edit earlier on to say we're going to look for true social security numbers. We're not going to look for anything that is just not defined. This looks like it might be closer to being a real social security number. So when we go ahead and paste it into our client folders, down in the lower right hand corner, it says, in fact, yeah, you're trying to leak something out. You're trying to do it from your machine. It's going to sync out to the cloud. We're not going to let you do that. And there it is. It's quarantined. Now we'll try another vector. This looks like Dropbox. Once again, a pop-up, and it's quarantined. The one at the top was OneDrive. Lastly, we have Box. It's quarantined. Okay. Now again, through video magic here, we have three different web browsers, Chrome, Firefox, and Explorer, and we're going to try to upload into the web interface, and you can see that it was blocked. So much for Box. That's not going to happen. How about Dropbox? We'll go ahead and upload it over to that vector. So we'll click on Upload Files. Browse on over to the SS number 2, and you'll see once again it gets blocked. These vectors are very important that we block both sides of it. Last of all, we have OneDrive through Office 365. There's SS, and we're going to try to upload it using a context menu here. And of course, we would expect it to be blocked. And if we get an additional note saying, sorry, there was a problem. The problem was that we're blocking it. Okay, we're going to head up to the DLP console and you're going to examine this. This is something you can look at any time. In fact, it's real time. If you have the console up, you would actually, as you had the notification, it would pop onto this notification history. We do a collect and send props, or in this case, send events. Either one will be just fine. And then we pop over to the DLP incident manager and you'll see that we have collected all of our blocks to the cloud and blocks to the web. It's Dropbox, Box, OneDrive. They were caught on all the vectors. So how about that? And now you two know how to create a rule to block cloud and web through a data protection rule. Look for other chapters describing other things to do with McAfee DLPe version 11. I'm Jay Appell. Thanks for watching.